The Princess and the Pea. Chapter 1. The Picky Prince. Once upon a time, there was a prince who wanted to marry a princess. But he didn't want just any old princess. He wanted a real one.
This is Princess Cordelia, Your Highness.
Not one of the local princesses would do.
What's the matter with them, Patrick?
Cried his father, the king.
I'm running out of princesses to show you. Are they too old? Too tall? Too hairy?
I can't be sure they're real, sighed Prince Patrick. I'll have to find one for myself.
You must do whatever you want, darling,
said the queen, who spoiled him rotten.
Nothing but the best for my Prince Winston.
Mother!
The next day, Prince Patrick set out to travel the world in search of a real princess. He took with him 12 suitcases, 10 pairs of shoes, a spare crown, and his cousin, Fred.
Ready, Freddy?
Oh, I think my arm's stuck.
Goodbye, my love,
cried the queen, wiping away a tear with her silk handkerchief.
Don't forget to wrap up wool.
And brush your teeth.
I'll be fine. Stop fussing.
They hadn't gone far when they heard a loud sneeze from under the seat.
Achoo! Who's there?
Shouted the prince. A small figure crept out.
It's Peg!
Aren't you the palace maid?
Said Prince Patrick. Peg nodded.
Well, what are you doing here?
The prince asked.
I want to see the world, said Peg. I've been at the palace all my life, ever since I was left on the doorstep as a baby. I want an adventure,
she blushed.
And cook's furious because I burned the pudding,
she added.
Well, you can't come with us, said Fred. This is a boy's only adventure.
You'll get scared and want to go home. No, I won't. I'm as brave as you.
We're not turning back now, said Prince Patrick. She'll have to join us.
Peg grinned at Fred.
Okay, Prince Patrick went on. First stop, the Wicked Witch's Hut.
Fred looked alarmed.
You are joking. She'll eat us alive.
Who's scared now?
Prince Patrick shook his head.
The witch will know how to find a real princess. She's my best hope.
Chapter 2. Off to see the witch.
Now, Peg, said Prince Patrick, this could be dangerous.
You stay in the coach. Fred and I will meet the witch.
The prince knocked 3 times on the witch's door. There was no answer.
Why couldn't I stay in the coach?
Looks like no one's in. We'll have to go, said Fred,
who was already backing away.
She must be in, said the prince,
and he bent down to peer through the keyhole. A large green eye was staring at him.
Ha!
Prince Patrick jumped back and landed bottom first in a patch of mud.
Oh, look at this mud!
A short, plump woman opened the door.
chuckling to herself. Did I scare you? I was just checking who you were. You can't be too careful these days. Fred was amazed.
Are you the witch?
He asked.
You're not scary at all.
The witch looked rather upset. I try my best, she sighed. I grew 3 new warts last week. Come inside, she added. I'm just cooking some tasty soup for lunch.
Something really spills in here. I think it's the soup.
We're not hungry, said Prince Patrick quickly. I've come to ask for your help. I want to know how to find a real princess.
Real princesses are very rare, said the witch, and it's hard to spot a fake one. But there is a test you can do. Let me see. A real princess must have boiled brains, rotten beans, and cat spit.
What? Cried the prince.
Oh, sorry. That's a recipe for soup.
This is it. The real princess test. A real princess must possess what? Politeness to one and all. Two, kindness to rich and poor. Three, very sensitive skin.
Sensitive skin? Prince Patrick asked, looking confused.
A real princess, explained the witch, has such tender skin that she could feel a pea under 20 mattresses.
Thank you, said the prince. You've been very helpful. He turned to the door.
Oh, do stay for lunch, pleaded the witch. My soup's almost ready.
No, really, I insist. And bring in that poor girl from outside.
Ugh, I can't eat that.
They were stuck in the witch's hut until the cauldron was empty.
Oh, I feel sick.
Groaned Peg on the way back to the coach.
Well, you shouldn't have had
what
beans then, said Fred.
That's me.
I poured mine into a platter.
I'm not banging.
I was being polite.
There's stuff at the bottom of a water bottle.
I didn't want to hurt the witch's feelings.
That was very kind of you, Peg, said Prince Patrick, smiling at her. Where are we going now? Asked Fred. Now I have the witch's test, I can finally find a real princess, said the prince. We're off to meet Princess Prunella. Check the map, Fred. Chapter 3. Princess Prunella. Princess Prunella was very excited to see the prince.
You must come and stay in my castle, she cried.
She raced over the bridge, dragging Prince Patrick with her.
Hurry, hurry, she called to her servants. He is perfect. We'll be married in no time. I want you to prepare the best bedchambers for the prince and Fred.
Excuse me, said Peg, struggling with all the luggage. Where am I to sleep?
Who are you?
I'm a maid.
Maids belong in the attic, replied the princess haughtily. There might be a few mice there, but I'm sure you'll cope.
Peg went to her room. It was cold and damp. She could hear mice scuttling about, squeaking.
Squeak, 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 squeak.
The prince can't marry her. Meanwhile, Fred and the prince were in the grand dining room with Princess Prunella.
You're being very kind, said Prince Patrick. But what about Peg? Is she eating in the kitchen?
The princess looked shocked.
Your beastly little maid? You can't expect me to bother with her. She can eat the pig slops if she's hungry.
I'm afraid we must leave, said Prince Patrick. You're not a real princess after all.
Oh, yes, I am, cried Princess Prunella.
Oh, no, you're not, shouted Fred. You failed the first real princess test.
Rats!
Real princesses are polite to everyone, explained Prince Patrick. And you've just been rude to Peg. Chapter 4. Princess Pavlova.
I won't give up, said Prince Patrick. There must be a real princess somewhere.
According to this map, there's a Princess Pavlova next door.
Let's try her,
Fred suggested. Princess Pavlova greeted them all very politely.
What a pleasure to have you here, she said.
Welcome to my castle.
Thank you, Your Highness.
She's passed the politeness test, thought the prince. Now what's the next one?
2. Kindness to rich and poor.
I have an idea.
Fred, he cried, I have a plan.
I'm going to dress up as a beggar and see if Princess Pavlova is kind to me.
Try out your disguise on Peg first, said Fred, to make sure it works.
Prince Patrick